We want to determine the derivative of the given function that involves the exponential function with base e. As you can see, we do have a quotient, so we will be applying the quotient rule given here. But I think it might be helpful to manipulate this function before we determine the derivative. Looking at these negative exponents, we could rewrite these as fractions as 1 over e to the x. Let's go ahead and do that. So to write this in a different form, we'd have e to the x minus 1 over e to the x divided by e to the x plus 1 over e to the x. Now, of course, we don't want to apply the quotient rule with these fractions in here, but if we multiply this by e to the x over e to the x, these fractions will simplify out. Let's see what this gives us. F of x is going to be equal to, well, e to the x times e to the x, when the bases are the same, we add the exponents, so we'd have e to the 2x minus 1 over e to the x times e to the x would be 1. The denominator, we would have e to the 2x and then plus 1. So I think it's going to be a little bit easier to apply the quotient rule when the function is in this form. So from here, we'll let the numerator equal f and the denominator equal g and apply the quotient rule. So to determine the derivative of the given function, we'll start with the denominator. The denominator is just the denominator squared, so we'll have e to the power of 2x plus 1 squared. The numerator is going to be g times f prime minus f times g prime, or the denominator times the derivative of the numerator minus the numerator times the derivative of the denominator. Now for the next step, we'll determine this derivative here and this derivative here. So let's continue this on the next slide. Now we'll determine these derivatives in yellow. To determine the derivative of e to the 2x, this is a composite function, so u would be equal to 2x, and the derivative of e to the u would be e to the u times u prime, or e to the 2x times 2. We'll write that as 2 e to the 2x minus quantity e to the 2x minus 1 times the derivative of e to the 2x plus 1. Well, again, we're going to have u equal to 2x. So the derivative will be e to the 2x times 2, or just 2 e to the 2x. So now we'll distribute here and then simplify the numerator. So we'll distribute here, 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 and here. So e to the 2x times 2 e to the 2x. Remember, if the bases are the same, we add the exponents. So we'll have 2 e to the 4x plus 2 e to the 2x. And over here we'll have minus 2 e to the 4x. And then we'll have minus negative 2 e to the 2x. That'll be plus 2 e to the 2x. Notice how these two terms are opposites, and these two terms are like terms. So our derivative is going to be equal to 4 e to the 2x divided by the quantity e to the 2x plus 1 squared. So here's our derivative function. So going back to the beginning just for a moment, we didn't have to manipulate this function to determine the derivative, but notice how when we did manipulate this to eliminate the exponents of negative x, it did result in a nice clean derivative as we see here. I hope you found this example helpful.